Good afternoon, guys. My name is Alina Shavtsova. I'm an immigration attorney from Brooklyn, New York. In today's video, I would like to share with you some quick updates regarding the most recent immigration news, the most interesting immigration news. So thank you very much for watching me. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do so and hit that notification bell button so you will stay updated timely regarding the most recent immigration news. So first of all, I would like to address news regarding bipartisan immigration bill. Bipartisan immigration bill, meaning that the bill was introduced or is currently being introduced by both Republicans and Democrats. What kind of bill is it? What is it about? Will it help with the immigration reform? Well, this bill actually is not aiming at resolving the issue that we hope an immigration reform would resolve, but it is the first step in helping the both parties to come to some sort of a agreement on the immigration reform. The bill is designed to have some measures in place when we have this migrant surges at the border, when we have this influx of people who come to the border and, as you know, media trying to portray it as the all-time crisis. So this bill was recently introduced just on Thursday, past Thursday, to address this particular situation. And specifically, it basically calls for funds and creation of processing centers at the border that will help to expeditiously process people who are coming to the border. It also calls for hiring more immigration judges and asylum officers, people who will be able to process all those who are coming to the southern border. And hopefully, if this bill is implemented, then we are going to have a system to deal with migrant surges, those unexpected or seasonal influx of migrants at the border, and then the issue of the border security and the border sealing will be resolved. Okay, will be resolved, which should help to lead to the comprehensive immigration reform that we are all waiting for. Now, from what I understand, the bill is being at the same time introduced with the Senate and with the House of Representatives to speed the things up. But as you know, it takes some time for the bill to go through various committees and commissions and vetting. So I'm not sure when the voting on the bill, on this particular bill, is going to take place, if it's going to take place at all. And perhaps it can become a part of a bigger bill. Perhaps. We do not know. So this is good news. I think at least both parties started talking to each other about how to resolve the immigration issue and how to start resolving the immigration issue. One more news I wanted to call your attention for is that by June of 2021, the United States Supreme Court is expected to make a decision about TPS holders. If TPS, or temporary protected status, is an admission or not. And if a person who received TPS status will be able to get a green card in the United States after they received such a status. A very important issue, you may know that currently there is a split between the federal courts as to whether TPS is admission or not. And if, let's say, you live in California and you receive TPS, you will be able to get a green card, even if initially you didn't have a legal entry. But if you live in New York, same circumstances, you will not be able to. So the U.S. Supreme Court is has heard oral arguments on the lawsuit in this matter and is expected to make decision in June. Very, very important decisions that may affect potentially millions of immigrants in the United States. So we're going to be waiting for that decision. And finally, I wanted to let you know that ICE rescinds penalties for failure to depart. What it means is that people who do not depart after they have orders of deportation, no longer are going to be subject to civil penalties, because there are some civil penalties and very serious civil penalties according to the law for someone who received an order of deportation but didn't leave the United States. I remember, if I recall correctly, a year or so ago, maybe a year and a half, there was a case in the media where a person was fined, I believe, $800,000 for failure to depart. For most immigrants, it's something unreal. These amounts are unreal. Of course, they're not realistic, but nevertheless, they can become judgments and can become something serious. But thankfully, this current administration rescinded this policy, and those penalties are no longer going to be enforced and are going to be rescinded. So I think it's very important news, especially very important news for those people who could have been subject to those penalties. So thank you guys very much for watching. Again, please like this video, share, subscribe to my channel, and I hope to see you soon.